Great new book, Grassroots Baseball, Where Legends Begin. Photographer Gene Fruth features more than 250 of the best images from all levels of the amateur game around the U.S. and all over the world. Legends like Vlad Guerrero, Hank Aaron, Randy Johnson, Nolan Ryan, Wade Boggs, and a whole lot more weigh in. The photos are amazing. It's a must-have for any baseball fan. And she joins us now with Jeff Idelson. You guys are the co-founders of Grassroots Baseball. So tell us what Grassroots Baseball is.
TC, Grassroots Baseball is all about celebrating the amateur game and giving back in underserved communities to try and grow the game. It's part of our game that's we feel underappreciated and underserved, and Gene and I are committed to doing that.
These images are amazing. I mean, you clearly have captured the spirit of the game around the world. How fun was it to put this project together?
Thanks for the kind words. It was an absolute blast. And as I traveled shooting Major League Baseball for my job in professional baseball, I always took time to shoot the amateur game. And then working with the Hall of Fame and meeting so many great Hall of Famers and hearing their stories, putting the two together just made a lot of sense. And
we're looking at some of them now, and many of them from the Cape League, which is, you know, for anybody who's gone to a Cape League game, that's where you kind of feel the soul of the game again, don't you?
Oh, yeah. I had a wonderful experience in the Cape League, and I was there for their championship game and for 2 weeks of playoffs, and it's just a special place. And when you see images from the Cape, there's no other place they're from. It's very much the Cape League.
I don't know how many times I've seen Major League players here at Fenway catching up with their host family from the Cape League. I mean, those are connections that last a lifetime.
They really are. And you look at Craig Biggio, who contributed a great essay to this, TC, and he talks about living with Mrs. B, the matriarch of the league. And then here 20 years later, his son Kevin, who's now with the Blue Jays, lived with Mrs. B as well.
Oh, that's awesome. Talk a little about that, getting these Hall of Famers to get engaged with this. Was it an easy sell when you threw the idea, Adam?
It really was, because, you know, Gene's concept is incredible. And when we went to the 13 Hall of Famers, 16 legends overall, we thought, geez, we better have a list two or deep, three deep. But TC, each guy that saw it said, absolutely love to do it.
Talk about that a little bit, their involvement. You sort of captured some of the images and brought the legends together with it. How did that all come together?
Yeah, as I already had almost all the images already shot when we were approaching the Hall of Famers for the different regions, and being able to show them images from their hometown, whether it's, you know, Don Gregorio and Vladimir Guerrero or Wade Boggs in Tampa. And it was really fun to show them. They love the sense of place. They love what was captured. And then putting their stories to it just made it so special.
Jeff, you just ended a quarter century at the Hall of Fame. Talk a little about the challenge of Grassroots Baseball now and the next chapter of your life.
Well, the Hall of Fame was great, but Grassroots Baseball is really, really looking forward to really pushing this with Gene out in a lot of channels. And, you know, it's a game that needs help. I mean, with travel ball, which is great, you're seeing it dwindle with kids who need that opportunity. So Gene and I are committed to promoting and really driving the amateur game. And, again, using Hall of Famers who are working with us to give back in underprivileged communities. We're going to be in Amarillo, Texas next week with Trevor Hoffman, and in Albuquerque a week later with Goose Gossage, going to Boys and Girls Clubs and working with those kids.
It's awesome, and good luck with the project. Anything we can do, obviously, because it's such a great story that needs to be told again. You know, for so long, we grew up in an era where Little League Baseball was something everybody did. It doesn't happen anymore. Other sports have chipped away at it. The Major League game has some issues it's got to deal with. So starting at the grassroots is a pretty good place to go.
We think so. And, you know, 8 years at the Major League level, starting right here in Boston in 86, and then going to the third base dugout with those guys, and then Cooperstown. But this is where my heart is, and working with Gene, we're really looking forward to giving a voice and amplification to kids.
Congrats on the book, and good luck. Thanks for dropping by.
Thanks, Tom.
We don't have a lot of camels on the show, but a former Conn College camel right here with us.